I'd like to show you the metal embossing technique. This is a beautiful way to use your rubber stamps to create something dimensional for your cards. Now, I have used the stamp set from Kanban, which are these gorgeous trees. I've also taken, of course, the sheets of metal quilting. This is available in different colours as well. I've taken two Pro Marker pens. I've got the Cocoa and the Forest Green. Stays on ink pad in jet black, some embossing tools, I need an embossing mat, and of course my acrylic blocks to get me started. So the first thing I'm going to do is take a piece of the metal and cut this with my scissors. Now do be careful, it can be very sharp at the ends of here, you are cutting metal. This is the brass one that I'm using. So I've got my little piece here now, ready for me to stamp. I'm going to take my stamp, I'm going to use a little tree, so just peel this backing off here, you can pick up the tree, this is one that I've already used, pop this on the acrylic block like so, and I'm going to use the stays on ink pad for this. I don't normally advise using stays on ink powder for acrylic stamps because it's solvent based, it can actually eventually melt down your stamp and make it quite tacky, so it's not advisable to overuse it. I'm doing this because it's the best ink pad to use on metal. One great thing though, there is now an all-purpose stays on cleaner which really helps clean your acrylic stamps. So worthwhile investing in this if you are going to use the stays on with these stamps. Got my stamp now in place, take my ink pad. You must always keep this little cover with the stays on to keep the ink nice and fresh. Put your stamp on the table, take your ink pad to the stamp and tap lightly over there to get your coverage. Pop that straight back in to there, position it above the metal, perfect of course because you can see exactly where you're stamping with the clear acrylics, and press firmly. Be careful that you don't move this around or rock it. Holding the metal on the table, lifting this off, and we now have our stamped impression. Now, thankfully, I've done one earlier, which is nice and dry, stays and dries quite quickly. This one, I've just ever so slightly rubbed and rocked it. Can you see how we've got a blurry image? So it might take you a few impressions to get it just right. This one, thankfully, I've got right earlier, so this is ready for me to go. Now, I'm going to take my little embossing pad. Really important to have this for this technique. It's this nice, spongy, thick pad. Pop that down. And I've got two embossing tools. One of them is a very fine point, one of them is more of a larger ballpoint embossing tool. I'm going to take the fine one first of all. And what I'm going to do is just run around the actual stamped image. So I'm pushing the indentation through. I've finished detailing the front of my stamped impression. I'm now going to flip this over and you can see the outline of all those little sections. I'm going to swap now to the ballpoint edge tool. Now, because I can see where those areas are, I'm going to use this to press those designs forward. So all of those areas, I want them to pop on the front side and have the shaping. So just go back in, go round the inner edge with this. I think I need to let my little dog in. She wants to come join us. Come on, Lou. Come on, baby. Just come for a bit of crafting. She'll go in her bed, under the table, and lie down. Okay. So just continue to do this to get all of those areas. So the outside circle following that first line, and then just run in a circular motion in the center of each of those sections. So now I've got my design embossed, I'm going to cut it out. So I take my scissors, I'm using my sharp little Fisker scissors, and carefully going around the edge of the design. I'm just cutting a few millimetres away from the edge of it. I'm just going all the way around there. If I have just disturbed anything there, I can pop it back down, as I have done just on the stump of the tray, and just go back and make sure if I've disturbed anything, I can just round all that back off again. Okay, so we're going to make the base card now for my tree to go on. I've got two of the Craftwork cards large scalloped, and I've got one of the smaller scallops. These are the rectangles. And to make my little card, I'm going to take the little scallop and score it. Now, this is a quick and easy way of doing it. I'm popping it in my trimmer, and I'm matching up the cutting line to where I want the score line to be. Now, you can actually get scoring blades for the Fiskars trimmers, but I haven't just got mine handy. And I want to show you another quick tip that you can use. I'm going to take the ballpoint embossing tool. Just make sure it's nice and level between those two points that I want to have it scored. And I just run in the actual groove, and I now have my score line. So all I have to do is fold that back, nice and easy, and then we're going to glue these two together. So I'm going to use the micro dots, or a strong double-sided adhesive would be great too. I'm going to micro dot the whole section of this, because I want it all the way down. So again, just make sure I've got a really good adhesive bit there. Pop that down onto the table, and then we need to line this up so it's a perfect match. Just squidge that out so it's lined up beautifully. Then I have taken the smaller one and very simply taken my Pro markers and gone around the edge just to add a tint of colour. And then with the green, just done little dots at the little tips of the scallops. And it just adds just a touch of colour to it. So this is one that I finished earlier, and that's going to sit onto my card there. What I need to do first of all is stamp the Thinking of You onto it. I'm not going to do that for speed. You can see the completed card. I'm just going to pop that onto here. So we've done the Thinking of You, and we've tied a little ribbon around there as well. So I'm just going to now attach this to the card. As you can see, I'm not going all the way to the edge. I'm going to put a few there, but because my card has a little overlap, I want to go all the way to the edge and just overlay that onto here. And then I'm going to take my little tree and I'm going to attach this too. And again, I'm going to do this with 3D foam. You could also do this with silicone glue. The solvent-based silicone glue is the best for this because you want it to have a really good firm hold. And it needs to be something that's raised. Need to cut that a little bit finer. It needs to be raised so that it allows the embossing to be shaped how we've created it. So just pop that behind. Take the backing off again. And we can now set this onto our card. Now we're going to pop that onto the card. And then I'm going to add the colour with the Pro markers. So very carefully now, take my Pro marker and colour in the little sections of the tree. Now, Pro markers are solvent based as well, so we want to be careful of not touching the solvent outline too much because it can actually move it. Solvent to solvent, it will sort of melt it down and take it with it. In fact, the best ink pads to use with the Pro markers, but they're not that suitable for on the metal, are the Memento or the Impress. I'm going to do the brown now as well. There we go. And I'm going to take one of the little flowers one. And this time, colour directly with the pens onto the stamp. And just stamp a little detail down here. There we go. And a little jewel in the centre of it. Down there. And you can see how my card is coming together. What we've done on this one is gone over and coloured again with the green, giving it a depth of colour. And we've put the thinking of you, which we should have stamped before we layered it, and the ribbon. So it really is a beautiful detail and something that's great fun for you to try. Another little card as well that I've created, just so you can see the technique, is with my sleepy owl. And on this one, we've actually spritzed over it with my spritzers, left that to dry, and heated it a little bit from behind, and it's given us this bubble, sort of aged look. And that was after we actually did the embossing. Otherwise, you're going to rub all of that off when you're embossing. But isn't it a fantastic look? So do have fun with metal. Be careful, but have great fun.